Welcome to the TMC Newsroom. My name is Rich Tehrani. Thanks for watching us today. We are coming to you from Interop, New York, 2011. And on our program is Robert Lin, the Director of Sales of Simena. Robert, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
You're welcome. So tell me about your company.
Simena, we were founded in 2002. We're headquarters there in Northern Virginia, right outside DC. Our first products were in the test and measurement space. We had a network emulator and a traffic generator. And then in 2009, we came up with a product called the Packet Flow Switch. And that's more in the network monitoring space. And that's the product that actually has driven revenues for this company since 2009.
So that's a popular thing at a show like this?
It's very popular. It fits right in with all the technology here.
So let's talk more about that. Tell me all about it. How's it different? What's it do?
So the Packet Flow Switch, we have two models, but our first one, 1524, was released in 2009. It looks like a standard Ethernet switch, 24 ports, except it's in the space called aggregation switch or network monitoring switch. And what it does is it will sit in a data center. A data center will have several network monitoring tools. So give you an example. A network monitoring tool, say it has four ports. It essentially can monitor four areas of the network, just to simplify things. To monitor another four areas of the network, you gotta get another network monitoring tool, and you can monitor another four. You get one of these tools and put an aggregation switch in front of it, 24 ports, you've extended the reach of that tool to 24 different areas of the network. Okay, so instead of buying maybe 5 or 10 tools, you would buy one aggregation switch and one tool. So that's a common application in data centers.
Okay. Now, tell me some other ways that customers might use the product in their network.
So we found a niche here with the financials. They do, the financials, big investment banks and exchanges, they do a lot of, I don't know if you're familiar with algorithmic trading, high-frequency trading.
Absolutely.
Okay, low latency.
Many of
stuff.
Our customers in tech and telecom are supporting the high-frequency trading
exactly.
markets.
So what they're doing is they need to measure latency on their network, and they have a latency monitoring tool, and there's various vendors out there. What we do is, just as I said, we would extend the reach of that tool. So we would tap the network, the outputs of the tap would go into our packet flow switch, and then we've aggregated many areas of the network into that one latency monitoring device. And since those devices are so expensive, you've optimized the one that you have and you get a better return on investment. So that's one such use case. Another one is when the customer's network has migrated to 10 gig, but their network monitoring tool is still at 1 gig. We have a lot of filtering and features such as packet slicing in that box that can filter that 10 gig traffic down so that you can still use their 1 gig tool. And then the last application that we're seeing more and more of is in the security monitoring space. This is where there's various IDS type security monitoring tools, each of them connected to, it would typically be a span port. Well, eventually, since there's so many different tools, you're gonna run out of span ports. So now with our product in between, what you do is you come from the span port into our packet flow switch, and you fan that out into several the various security monitoring devices.
Great. So it's a very flexible tool, it sounds like.
It's a very flexible tool. It's just a growing space. The space has grown, and we're part of that growth.
So any other news at the show?
So we are announcing our packet flow switch 1764, and that's our new product. I mentioned the 1524 was 24 ports. This one is actually going to be 64 ports. Okay, so it's 48 10 gig ports and 40 gig ports. So what makes this product unique, same with our 1524, is we have a open Linux in our control plane. And what that means is we can come up with features very quickly and implement them very quickly. So for example, originally we came up with features, I mentioned packet slicing and port tagging. Packet slicing is the ability to slice down a packet to pass along maybe just the header information. Port tagging is a way to assign a VLAN tag to an ingress port so you can tag that packet. So once it's aggregated, you know where it came from. We came up with these features fall of 2009, a year before everybody else, because we have an open Linux platform. If you're not using Linux, you're either using an FPGA or an ASIC. Okay. So what some of these folks will come people using ASICs will say, well, a Linux platform is not going to have the performance that we have. Well, we partner with a very fast Ethernet switching partner. This is a very well-known name in the industry, and that is the engine that provides the switching. So we have wire speed among all our 10 gig ports. We have the very lowest latency port to port. And our 1764 is basically using the next generation of this chip. But this time, we're taking this chip and putting it into our own reference design. It's going to be included with an 8-core multiprocessor, and therefore all the buzzwords in this space, time stamping, packet deduplication, microburst detection, deep packet inspection, we have all that in this
box.
That's
great.
And we can easily develop in this box.
And so, I mean, you've talked a lot about what's happening, but is there anything else that we don't know about that's coming in the future?
This is the main box. I mean, it's just an open Linux platform. That's our theme, very open. We feel like hardware-wise, everyone's going to be at the same level. And what's going to distinguish these products in the future is just is the software. So the hardware, we feel we have the best hardware out there.
Great.
And we're just making distinguishing ourselves with the software, with all the features and everything like
Thanks
that.
Thanks for being here, Robert.
Okay.
Great to meet you.
Thanks a lot.
Pleasure.